the fact that the fabric of life on Earth may be running out is a major, major issue. So if we don't start to look after our soil, we literally erode the fabric of civilization. The stuff that makes us alive are tiny, tiny amounts of micronutrients that are found in soil, without which we simply couldn't survive. If they're not in soil, they're not in your food. If they're not in the food, they're not in you. So it is important that we understand this connection, that people understand this very intimate connection between soil and their well-being. Everywhere you look in the world where we are using soil, we're not using it sustainably, so we're losing it faster than it's being made. In the next 20 or 30 years, we're going to have to find at least half as much more food to feed the world than we're producing at the moment. Already, we are producing more food from a hectare of land than we've ever produced in the history of human society. And we're going to have to almost double that. And that's incredible in itself. Going forward, I think we need to refocus our attention on why we grow food. It's not just to stop us getting hungry, but it's actually to keep us healthy. Australia has a potentially very significant role to play in the global solution. We currently produce enough food for 60 million people, which is more than the population, which means we export a lot. And the amount of food that we export has a major impact on food prices. I've worked on problems relating to the origin of the universe, to curing cancer and things like that in my career. By far the most challenging, difficult and important problem I'm working on is the one I'm working on now, which is how do we get soil fixed in a way that can support the rest of the terrestrial biosphere indefinitely.